What's up, beautiful people? It's your boy Joshua Martin. In this video, I'm going to be answering the question, why invest in a mobile setup like this? If you're anything like me, having the best quality in your gear is really important to you. And I have to say, this setup here addresses my wants and needs. Starting with the optics, the iPhone 8 Plus is a huge improvement from the 7. As we all know, there's plenty of reviews out there, but the dynamic range, the tonal capture, the better 4K, it's sharper, the image stabilization, it's all the total package. There are also several types of gimbals on the market, and I have been debating what would be the best fit for me and what I was looking for. And actually, the top three factors that helped me determine what I wanted in my gimbal was durability, features, and camera movement, the actual movement of the gimbal. The DJI Mobile had at least two of the three factors I was looking for. It was built really, really well. The gimbal was very responsive, and it worked with all the third-party apps, like Filmic Pro. This is actually the app I prefer rather than the DJI app. The biggest reason is because Filmic Pro can unlock the various features when it comes to 4K recording, 4K in 24p, 30p, and 60p, along with various frame rates that you can record in. But what really makes the Filmic Pro app sing is coupled with the Anamorphic Moondog Labs lens. This lens allows you to create anamorphic looks to your video. Now, you can always get other adapters and other lenses to your phone. I recommend getting moment lenses, but I chose this lens because I really enjoy and love the look and aesthetic of anamorphic glass. Basically, the lens compresses your image to a 4:3 ratio, retaining the height of your picture and pulling in the left and right frame. Some of the other characteristics of the anamorphic lens is that you get these long bar flares, just like J.J. Abrams, that's what they shoot on, is anamorphic, and along with the curved and oval bokeh and the curved lines that appear. So none of the lines on the edges look straight, it's always that bow look. First, you want to attach your gimbal to a tripod mount. Now, in this case, they didn't put the mount underneath the gimbal, they put it on the left side of it. Which allows you to use their attachments to their tripod and things like that. But luckily, with my setup, my plate can fit in that space to attach it to my own tripod. So you want to do that if you want to put it on a tripod or buy the base that they have as well. There's actually a package deal that B&H is selling where you can buy the counterweight, the gimbal itself, and the anamorphic lens. And I'll link that in the description below. Like I said earlier, they do sell a counterweight with this package, but you can also just do it DIY. There's a few videos online that show you how you can either hot glue or sticky or mount something to the edge of it so you can balance this out. I prefer just buying it. It works perfectly well, but there are some small changes that you have to make sure it balances perfectly. With the counterweight itself, it's really cool because it's magnetic, so it fits to the corner of the arm. You slide out the arm all the way, you place your counterweight on it, and then you slide it close enough where it touches the screw, and you tighten it that way, and that's actually the perfect fit for this, especially with the lens at the end, so it perfectly balances. If it's too far out with the weight, it won't balance correctly. With actually using the gimbal, either on a tripod or walking with it, just like any gimbal, you have to have the proper movement when using it, especially handheld. So don't think you just sit up there and walk with it. You're always going to get micro shakes and things like that. So bend your knees, and so you can get those smoother shots from your phone. Now, one thing I have noticed, when I was filming with the gimbal outside, when there's a slight amount of breeze, there's a significant amount of shake. There's a little wobble, especially with the time lapse. So that's something to keep in mind. I don't know how to fix it because the gimbal itself is not aerodynamic and you have a flat phone up there. So any type of wisping around it is going to create the shake. Now, to finally answer the question, is this setup worth it? I will say yes for the build quality, for the features that you can get with it. And if you want to pair it up with your iPhone 8 Plus, the iPhone 7 Plus, the Galaxy, they will all work. This gimbal can hold their weight. If you do want to add other attachments, you need a counterweight for any other lenses that you put on it, like moment lenses or the anamorphic lenses or anything like that. But if this is something that you want to be able to use just for casual capturing of day-to-day stuff, vlogging styles, any other styles, you can really push the limits with your phone with a setup like this. So that's my thoughts. I hope this was informative. It's a little messy, but hey, things will get better in the long run. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel. follow me on Instagram because you'll get all the behind the scenes as well. And just let me know what your thoughts are at the bottom in the comments. All right, deuces.